Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the active low pass and the active high pass filter. So in the last couple of videos, we had seen that how by just using the resistor and capacitor, we can design the passive RC low pass and the high pass filters. But these passive filters have some limitations. The first limitation is that the output of this passive filter will be always less than the input signal. And when you cascade many of such filters to design the higher order filter, the output will be even much lesser than the input. And not only that, the cutoff frequency of such passive filters will also depend upon the load. So depending upon the load value, the cutoff frequency of such passive filters will get modified. Like as you can see in this high pass passive filter, depending upon the load value, the effective resistance of this filter will get modified, and hence the cutoff frequency will also get modified. So these problems can be overcome by using the active filter. So this active filter not only selectively passes the certain band of frequencies, but it also provides the gain to the input signal. And as its name suggests, these active filters are designed using the active components like op-amp and the transistors. So in this video, we will see the active low pass and the high pass filters, which are designed using the op-amp. Now the main advantage of op-amp is it has a very high input impedance and very low output impedance. So because of these characteristics, we can use op-amp as a buffer to isolate the load from the filter circuitry, or maybe we can use to isolate the different stages of the filter. So now let us see how we can use this op-amp as a buffer. So when we configure op-amp as a voltage follower circuit, then it will act as a buffer. So in that case, we are providing an input to this non-inverting end of this op-amp, and output is getting shorted with the inverting end of the op-amp. So in this configuration, the output will be equal to the input. So we can say that the gain of the op-amp is 1. So now in this configuration, suppose if we connect our filter circuit at this non-inverting end, and if we take the output at this end, then this op-amp will act as a buffer between the load and the filter circuit. But in this configuration, the gain of this op-amp will be 1. So now suppose if we want to amplify the filter output, then we can configure this op-amp in this configuration. So this is known as a non-inverting amplifier configuration of the op-amp, in which we are providing the input at this non-inverting end and we are taking output over here. So in this configuration, the gain or DC gain of this op-amp will be 1 divided by RF plus R1. So by changing the value of this feedback resistance and the value of R1, we can change the gain of this op-amp. So in this configuration, suppose if we connect our filter circuit at this end, then the output of the filter will get amplified by this factor, and the circuit will look like this. So here will be the input to the filter, and here we will take the output of this filter. And let us say the intermediate stage, which is the input to this non-inverting end, will be Vx. So for the low frequencies, the gain which is being provided by this op-amp will be 1 plus RF by R1. And let us denote that gain by a symbol AV. That is a voltage gain that is provided by this op-amp. Now in this configuration, the cutoff frequency will be FC, that is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi into RC, which is the same expression that we got for the passive low pass filter. So now earlier in the case of a passive low pass filter, we had seen that the ratio of output divided by the input is known as the transfer function of this filter. So let us see how we can write the transfer function for this active low pass filter. So the transfer function of this active low pass filter can be given by the equation AV into 1 divided by under root 1 plus F over FC whole square, where AV is nothing but 1 plus RF by R1. That is the gain that is provided by the op-amp. So in this expression, there are two components. The first is the voltage gain of the op-amp, that is the AV. And the second component is this expression, that is 1 over under root 1 plus F by FC whole square. And that is the response of a low pass filter. And if you are wondering how we have arrived to this expression, so let us derive this expression. So in the case of a passive low pass filter, we had seen that the output can be given by the expression Xc divided by Xc plus R into Vin, or we can write this expression as Vout by Vin, that is equal to Xc divided by under root R square plus Xc square, or we can write it as a 1 over omega c divided by under root R square plus 1 over omega c whole square. Now suppose if we multiply numerator and denominator by the term omega c, then we will get 1 divided by under root R square into omega square c square plus 1. Now we know that for the low pass filter, the cutoff frequency omega c can be given by the equation 1 over RC. So we can write this expression as Vout by Vin, that is equal to 1 divided by under root 1 plus omega over omega c whole square, where omega c is nothing but a 1 over RC. And if we write this expression in terms of the frequency, then we can write it as a 1 divided by under root 1 plus f over fc whole square. So in this way, we got the expression for this output over input for the passive low pass filter. And if we multiply this expression by the op-amp gain, then that will be multiplied by the expression 1 plus rf divided by r1. So this will be the transfer function of a active low pass filter. And if we see the frequency response of the active low pass filter, it will be very similar to the passive low pass filter. So this filter have a cutoff frequency of fc, where the output will be 0.707 times the maximum value. So now, so far we had seen that by using the op-amp we can isolate the load and the filter circuit. But what if my input that is coming to this filter is also coming from the another circuitry? So in that case, it is quite possible that depending upon the impedance of that circuit, the cutoff frequency of this filter will get changed. And to avoid that, what we can do, we can provide that input to this filter by using a one buffer circuit. But in that case, we will require one more buffer. And if we want to eliminate one more buffer, then what we can do, we can connect this capacitor in the feedback path, and that circuit will look like this. So in this case, we are applying an input at the non-inverting end, and instead of connecting the capacitor at this end, we have shifted that capacitor in the feedback path. So now let us understand how this circuit will also act as a low pass filter. So at low frequencies, or let us take an extreme case, at zero frequency, the value of Xc will be infinity, and hence the parallel impedance of this Xc and Rf will be Rf. So at low frequencies, the gain that is provided by this op-amp will be 1 plus Rf over R1. And as we move towards the higher frequencies, or let us take a case at f is equal to infinity, the value of this reactance will be 0. And in that case, this op-amp will act as a voltage follower. So at that time, the output will follow the input, and hence the gain will be equal to 1. So in this way, this circuit will also act as a low pass filter. And by using this configuration, we can avoid the effect of loading from the input stage. But the cutoff frequency for this filter can be given by the expression 1 divided by 2 pi into Rf into C. So as you can see, our cutoff frequency has been slightly modified, because now the resistance which decides the characteristic of the filter is not R, but this feedback resistor Rf. And the gain of this op-amp will be given by the expression 1 plus Rf over R1. Alright, so now let us take one example based on this active low pass filter. So in this example, we have been given to find the cutoff frequency for the given filter. So as you can see here, this filter is used in a non-inverting configuration. And we know that the cutoff frequency expression for this filter will be 1 divided by 2 pi into RC. Now here the value of R is 10 kilo ohm, and the value of capacitance is 0.1 microfarad. So now if you put all the values of this resistance and capacitance, then the cutoff frequency will be approximately equal to 150 9 hertz. And if you see here, the gain of this filter will be 1 plus RF by R1, that is nothing but a 5. So in this way, suppose if you are applying a signal of a 1 volt with a 1 hertz frequency, then at the output you will get a output signal of a 5 volt with a 1 hertz frequency. So now, like we have designed the active low pass filter, similarly we can design the active high pass filter. And here is the circuit of an active high pass filter with a unity gain. So here this op-amp is used as a buffer to isolate the load and the filter circuitry. And suppose if you want to amplify the filter output, then we can configure this high pass filter in this configuration, which is very similar to the we had seen for the active low pass filter. So the gain of this filter will be 1 plus RF divided by R1, and the cutoff frequency FC can be given by the expression 1 divided by 2 pi into RC. So in this filter we are applying the input at this end and we are taking the output over here. So now let us see the expression for the transfer function for this active high pass filter. So the transfer function for this active high pass filter can be given by the expression AV into F by FC divided by under root 1 plus F by FC whole square. So here AV is nothing but 1 plus RF by R1, that is the gain which is provided by the op-amp. So again here, as you can see, this expression have a two components. One is the gain that is provided by the op-amp and one is the response of a high pass filter. So now let us derive this expression. So in the last video we had seen that for the high pass filter, the ratio of output over input can be given by the expression R divided by under root R square plus XC square, or we can say that R divided by under root R square plus 1 over omega C whole square. So now if we multiply numerator and denominator by the term omega C, then we will get R into omega C divided by under root R square into omega square C square plus 1. And we know that for the high pass filter, the cutoff frequency omega C will be 1 over RC. So we can write this expression as omega divided by omega C divided by under root 1 plus omega divided by omega C whole square. And if we write in terms of the frequency, then we can say that F by FC divided by under root 1 plus F by FC whole square. So this will be the expression of a transfer function for the passive high pass filter. And if we multiply this expression by the gain of a op-amp, then we will get a expression for the active high pass filter. So now if we see the frequency response of this active low pass filter, it should look very similar to the passive high pass filter. That means it rejects the low frequency component and it passes all the high frequency components up to the infinity. But if you see the actual filter, it will not pass all the frequency components up to the infinity, and the frequency response is limited by the electrical components that is used in the design. Particularly in this case, if you see, the response is limited by the gain characteristic of the op-amp. So if you see the gain characteristic of the op-amp, it will look like this. So this op-amp provides the flat response for a frequencies, let us say up to the 100 kilohertz or maybe 1 megahertz. And if you go beyond these frequencies, then you will see the reduction in the gain. So now if we see the combined response, then the combined response of this active low pass filter will look like this. So this will be the response of our active low pass filter. So now, so far whatever active filters we have designed, we have provided the input at the non-inverting end of this op-amp. But we can also design this active filters by providing the input at this inverting end. And if you see the active low pass filter in the inverting configuration, it will look like this. So here in this inverting configuration, the gain of the op-amp will be minus RF by R1. So as you can see, the gain will be the minus RF by R1. So the output will be 180 degree out of phase with the input. And the cutoff frequency FC can be given by the expression 1 divided by 2 pi into RF into C. Similarly, we can design the active high pass filter in a inverting configuration. That means we are providing the input at this inverting end of the op-amp. So now suppose if you want to design the higher order filters, then we can cascade this first order active filters and we can design the higher order filters. And we will see more about it in the upcoming videos. So before I end up this video, here I am giving you one exercise which is very simple. So as you can see in this example, you have to design the high pass filter which is having a cutoff frequency of 5 kHz. And not only that, for this filter, whenever you are applying an input signal, let's say of 100 millivolt with a frequency of 10 kHz, then at the output, you should get a output of a 1 volt with a 10 kHz. So you have to select the value of this RF, R1, C and R in such a way that all these criteria will be fulfilled. And do let me know your designed values in the comment section below. So I hope in this video you understood about the active low pass and the high pass filters. So if you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.